now can I request our Honorable Member of Parliament, Sri Gokulakrishnan sir.
At the outset, I welcome the delegate present in this August gathering, and I am proud to be part of it on this occasion. I am very happy that two great nations, India and Vietnam, which have been championing the cause of liberty, freedom and human rights, and fought against colonialism throughout this history, have come together to cement the cooperation on the business sector and move forward. Being a Puducherryan, the event has a special historical significance for me, because an event in Vietnam's anti-colonial war played a crucial role in getting liberation of Puducherry from the colonial French rule in 1954. The socialist government headed by Pierre Mendel, France, which came to power in 1954, thankfully remembered and respected the strategic and humanitarian intervention of our great leader, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, in saving the life of 2 lakh French soldiers trapped in a mountain valley from the Viet Minh Army. Yet, communist dominated rationalist nationalist movement formed in 1941 that fought for Vietnamese independence from French rule. Members of the Viet Minh later joined with the Viet Cong. The great warrior Mr. Ho Chi Minh, the supreme commander of Vietnamese force, who had been a great friend of Nehruji, responded favorably to his request, and that saved the French soldiers from the slaughter. In this background, I am sure that with a long cherished friendship, Puducherry and Vietnam can inter alia extend cooperation in exploring the possibilities of economic opportunities and benefit mutually. This roundtable workshop is concentrating on science and technology as an instrument for improving relations between these two countries. On our side, I need not emphasize that India has forged ahead as a pioneer in the field of science and technology in the recent years. We have revolutionized the agriculture sector and modernized industrial sector and cutting edge technologies. Our achievement in the space sector is astounding, with our mission to Mars and Moon. Several Indian firms are registering their strong presence in many countries on the sphere of infrastructure. On the management side, the Indian Institute of Management has earned very high in the ranks amongst the quality institutions across the world. On the economic front, India has emerged as the third economic superpower and promises to move further. Therefore, there will be ample opportunities for us to collaborate with the Vietnamese government. At the same time, I am also eager to listen to the delegates from that republic to tell us what is in store for us. Long live India-Vietnam friendship. Thank you.